high endowment.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, one thing generally to start this off is Ivy League was originally started as a sports league. Mm-hmm. So this was not meant for schools of academic excellence. It just so happens these are among the oldest schools in the country. And because of that, they've gotten the greatest level of prestige, and in a lot of cases, they've accumulated the greatest amount of wealth. Mm-hmm. So these schools have, in some cases, tens of billions of dollars that are just sitting in the bank, and they can use that for a whole variety of initiatives. They often use it to hire big-name professors. So if you go to an Ivy League school, it's not going to be uncommon to see someone on TV and then have them teach your class later that day.
Hello, class. I'm your physics teacher, Yingling Peng. I've been teaching here at Harvard for over 6 years. I have a master's degree in economics and a PhD in physics. I graduated at the top of my class at Princeton. Last year, I received the Teacher of America Award along with my fourth Nobel Prize with the study of physics. I want to formally welcome you, Harvard.
Here are just a few of the many highly successful professors Ivy League schools have to offer. To work with these faculty is to engage in a study at the farthest reaches of the subject.
Another pro, which is that you have the Ivy League brand and the alumni network that comes with going to an Ivy League school, and a lot of people in power do tend to be from Ivy League schools.
Yeah, and that is important, especially if you're considering going all throughout the United States in your career or if you're going internationally. There are some great schools in America that don't have the same name recognition, but going to an Ivy League school, no matter where you are, people know that brand, they associate it with you for the rest of your life. And when you do graduate, you enter into a very powerful alumni network who may be willing to help you throughout the entirety of your career.
You must be Judd. My name's Logan Kazmarek. Nice to see you at the company. What you got?
Here's my resume.
Okay. So it says here that you spent 3 nights in jail.
Yeah.
2.0 GPA. No extracurricular activities. Oh, cool! It says you attended Yale.
Oh, you too?
Yeah, graduated class of 97 myself.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I had like the time on an app at Yale.
Oh.
Best decision I've ever made.
I feel you. Same here. So, yeah. Yeah, this resume looks great. Yeah, you're hired.
You think so?
You're hired.
Thanks, man.
Find are these Ivy League schools have more money for research and more interesting summer programs. So students at an Ivy League, if you want to spend the summer researching the homeless issue in Guatemala, you're going to be more likely to get dollars to go out there and try that yourself, which is definitely a perk.